Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Today, in this video, we are going to learn a class 9 English poem, The Bold Peddler and Robin Hood. It's written by Francis J. Child. So let us see about the poem and the poet. But before that, students, if you are viewing my video for the first time, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notifications of all the upcoming videos. If watch the video till end, and if you like it, do hit the like button and share with your friends. So let's move on to the poet. So as we saw that the poet of this poem is Francis James Child. He was born on February 1, 1825 till September 11, 1896. He was an American scholar, educator and folklorist. Is best known today for his collection of folk songs known as the Child Ballads. Child was Boylston Professor of Rhetoric and Oratory at Harvard University, where he produced influential editions of English poetry. In 1876, he was named Harvard's first professor of English, a position which allowed him to focus on academic research. It was during this time that he began working on the Child Ballads. The Child Ballads were published in 5 volumes between 1882 and 1898. They are the major contribution to the study of English language folk music. So students, here we come to know about this poet that he was a good American scholar, he was an educator, he was a folklorist, and he was famous for child ballads. Now, what are ballads? Ballads are the long poems. Actually, those are the stories which are written in the form of long poems. So these were, he was famous for this ballads. And he was also a professor, and all his works were very well known, and it had become very famous, and it helped in many research works. So this is the contribution of this poet. So let us see the poem now. What do we have in this? We'll read stanzas, few lines, and then we'll see the explanation of it. Okay, so here we go. There chanced to be a peddler bold. A peddler bold there chanced to be. He put his pack all on his back, and so merrily trudged over the lea. By chance he met two troublesome men. Two troublesome men they chanced to be. The one of them was bold Robin Hood, and the other was little John so free. O peddler, peddler, what is in thy pack? Come speedily and tell to me. Okay, so these are first 10 lines, students, so we'll just understand the meaning. So this is a story written in a kind of a poem. This is actually a ballad, so that's why it's like this. And here we find that the questions, the sentences are repeated, and it is as if you are asking some questions, but it is just for the confirmation. So that is known as rhetoric questions, where you don't expect the answers, but you ask or repeat the sentence for confirmation. Okay, so let us see, while we read, we'll understand that. So here there was a peddler who was going, he was very bold enough, very bold peddler, and he was going once in the forest. Okay, he met a bold peddler, and he was having on his back a full pack, some luggage he was having, a pack means some luggage he was having, he was carrying on his back. And so merrily trudged over the lea. Means so happily and merrily he was walking. Thrust means walking slowly with small steps. While you get tired, how you take up small steps and you walk so lazily. So trudged means that, walking with the heavy steps. And he was walking with the heavy steps over the lea. Lea are nothing but the garden or the grass, the forest which is having grass on it. So he was walking merrily on this lea. By chance he met two troublesome men. Now while walking on this lea, on this grassy land, he met two troublesome men there. The two troublesome men they chanced to be. So here you notice, students, that this sentence is repeated again, and this is known as a rhetoric question. Like, you are not expecting any answer, but you need confirmation there. That's why you have repeated in as if you are asking a question. Okay, so he met two troublesome men there by chance, and The one of them was bold Robin Hood, and the other was little John So Free. So there were two men. One was very bold Robin Hood, who is famous, and you know he was a very good fighter. So one among them was Robin Hood, and the other was a little John who was along with Robin Hood. And they met this bold peddler here. So as soon as they met each other, they asked, "Oh, peddler, peddler, what is in thy pack?" John started asking, "Oh, peddler, what is in your pack? Come speedily and tell to me. Like, tell me, what do you have on your pack? What are you carrying with you?" Then, "I have several suits of the gay green silks and silken bowstrings by two or three." If you have several suits of the gay green silk and silken bowstrings two or three, then by my body, cries little John, one half of your pack shall belong to me. "Oh nay, oh nay," said the peddler bold, "oh nay, oh nay, that can never be, for there's never a man from fair Nottingham can ask one half my pack from me." So see, you like a story, you understood that there was a peddler who was walking and he got two troublesome men. One was Robin Hood, the other was John. He asked, "What are you carrying in your bag?" So he's answering that, "I have suits of gay green silk. I'm having a silken clothes in my pack, and I also have a silk bowstrings, like bow and arrow, which you use for archery. And by two or three, like maybe two or three, I'm having strings with me, which are of silk." So he says, suddenly the John replies, "If you have several suits of green silk and if you're having silken bowstrings, then the pack will belongs to me. The half of the pack which you're carrying, it belongs to me. It means you need to give it to me." He was trying to rob that. He wanted to have his half share in that. So now peddler, he did not become frightened. See how he is very courageously and bravely he's answering. He's saying, "Oh nay, oh nay," said the peddler bold, "oh nay, oh nay, that can never be." Like he's refusing, "No, this cannot happen. It belongs to me. How can you take a share? How can half of it belong to you? It can never happen like that." And he says that there was a never man from Nottingham who would anytime say me like this. Like he was so bold enough that nobody else from the Nottingham or the area where he used to live, or where he particularly was at the time, can ever say that the pack belongs to them or they have a share in it. So nobody can ask half of my pack from me. So boldly he was answering and replying these two people, that is Robin Hood and John. Okay, so let's move on. Then the peddler, he pulled off his pack and put it a little below his knee, saying, "If you do move me one perch from this, my pack and all shall gang with thee." Then little John, he drew his sword. The peddler by his pack did stand. They fought until they both did sweat, till he cried, "Peddler, pray hold your hand." Then Robin Hood, he was standing by, and he did laugh most heartily. Okay, so here we see that the peddler started, he stood there, he answered first that no, you cannot have a share in it. And then he pulled off his pack, means he just removed his pack and just kept below the knee, like he just kept it on the ground, and he started giving them a challenge. He challenged them that, "Let us have a small fight here, and even if a step you can make me move here and there, then the whole pack shall be yours." Like that, he had a very he gave a challenge to them. Now the little John, he was very confident, he was ready, and he drew his sword. He took out his sword, and the peddler was standing near his pack, and they started began to fight with the swords, and until the sweat, means the fight went on, until he cried, until the small boy, that is John, he was tired. He prayed to peddler, "Hold your hand," means wait a minute, like he was tired, and he said to hold on. And then the Robin Hood was there, who was watching while he was standing at the side, and he was laughing heartily because he was seeing the fight and he was laughing heartily. See here, this peddler, he did not lose hope. He was so confident, he was so brave that he was not even tired at all. Then let us see. "Saying, I could find a man of smaller scale, could thrash the peddler and also thee. Go you try, master, says little John. Go you try, master, most speedily. For by my body, says little John, I'm sure this night you will know me. Then Robin Hood, he drew his sword, and the peddler by his pack did stand. They fought till the blood in streams did flow, till he cried, peddler, pray hold your hand. Now when he was tired, he said Robin Hood to go and continue the fight. Because he's saying, you know, I'm a small boy, I'm John, but I'm tired now, so go you try, master. He's sending his master, that is Robin Hood, and he's saying, go master and fight more speedily. And now I'm sure that this night he will come to know, the peddler will come to know who I am and who the Robin Hood is. So the Robin Hood started the fight with his sword. He drew his sword, he took out his sword, and he started to fight. And the peddler, he was still standing near his pack. He had not even moved from there. At one place, standing at one place, he was fighting so bravely. And again, the fight went on without any, without any stop in between. And they fought till the blood in streams did flow. Till the blood started flowing from either of the parties. They continued to fight. And till he cried, peddler, pray hold your hand. Now here, the Robin Hood, who is known for his fighting, even he was tired here because he got such a tough competition and such a tough fight here. And even he was tired and he cried, means he pleaded him to hold your hand, means wait for a minute. Then let us see what he says. Now after that he says, O peddler, peddler, what is thy name? Come speedily and tell to me. Come, my name, I never will tell. Tell both your names you have told to me. The one of us is bold Robin Hood, and the other is little John so free. Now, says the peddler, it lays to my goodwill whether my name I chose to tell to thee. I am Gamble Gold of the gay green woods, and I traveled far beyond the sea. Okay, so now when the Robin Hood, he himself was tired, he said him to wait for a minute, and then he asked, oh peddler, peddler, say me, who are you, what is your name, come fast and say me your name. But the peddler said, no, I'll not tell my name until both of you tell your names to me. Then the Robin Hood says that the one of us is bold Robin Hood, I'm the bold Robin Hood, and the other one is the little John. So now the peddler says, okay, now it's my turn and I'll say my name. And I am Gamble Gold of the gay green woods. And I have traveled a long distance from far beyond the sea and have reached here. Now let's see what further he says. For killing a man in my father's land and from my country was forced to flee. If you are Gamble Gold of the gay green woods and traveled far beyond the sea, you are my mother's own sister's son. What nearer cousins can we be? They sheathed their swords with friendly words. So merrily they did agree. They went to a tavern and there they dined and cracked bottles most merrily. Okay, so here further he says that I have traveled from a long distance from far off sea, and I have killed a man in my father's land where I used to live, where my family lives. There I have murdered a person, and from there I have escaped. I have fled from my country. And if now after listening to this, Robin Hood says that if you are a Gamble Gold, and if you are coming from gay green woods, and you have traveled beyond the sea such a long distance, and you have come here, it seems that you are my mother's own sister's son. So you are my cousin in that way. So what better or nearer cousins or relations can we have together? After listening to this, they sheathed, means they kept the swords inside the covers, and they had friendly words there, and they happily agreed each other as siblings, and they went to tavern. Now tavern is a small hotel or a place where you have a drink and you enjoy, you eat some food. They dined there, they had a drink, they cracked bottles in the sense they had a drink together, and they were happily living there. They enjoyed the moment there. So this is how the fight stopped, and the brave person, two brave siblings met here. Okay, so this is what the poem about. I hope students you all have understood the poem. It was informative for you all. If you liked the video, do hit the like button and share with your friends. Keep watching my videos. We'll be back soon with more such videos. Thank you.